Hello, I am Professor C.P. Prakasam, former professor, International Institute for Population Sciences, Mumbai. I will be discussing about measures of maternal mortality, part 1, where the information for the calculation of the rates and ratios depends upon collection of the data. We will be learning in this discussion what is the definition of maternal mortality, what are the measures of maternal mortality, and the source available for the maternal mortality data. Maternal mortality, according to the WHO, they have defined that the deaths during the pregnancy, childbirth, or within 42 days of the termination of the pregnancy, irrespective of the duration of the site of the pregnancy in a specific year. Here, this is the most important thing, that the deaths due to delivery, due to pregnancy and delivery within the 42 days of the termination of the pregnancy. Therefore, this is solely depends upon the time of death, not related to the order of pregnancy or the order of the child and other things. Therefore, to measure this maternal mortality, four methods are available on the basis of the data. One is the maternal mortality ratio, maternal mortality rate, proportional mortality, adult lifetime risk maternal deaths, and lifetime risk of maternal mortality, that will be discussed here. The first measure is the maternal mortality ratio. Maternal mortality ratio is defined as the number of maternal deaths per 1 lakh number of live births. The denominator is refers to measuring of the obstetric risk. Maternal mortality ratio overestimates the obstetric risk because the denominator consists of number of live births, not the pregnancy loss. Therefore, overestimation will be there. Then MMR ratio is not an age standardized measure. That's why the comparison with the other countries and other provinces is not possible for this. Then the second measurement is the maternal mortality rate. Maternal mortality rate is the number of maternal deaths per number of women in the age group 15 to 49 per thousand. Therefore, maternal mortality rate is an indicator of risk of maternal deaths among the women in the reproductive age 15 to 49. This is also called a cause-specific death rate because women in the denominator belongs to reproductive age and who are likely to expose it for the maternal deaths. That's why it is called the cause-specific death rate related to that maternal mortality. Then the relation between the maternal mortality ratio and maternal mortality rate is also established. The maternal mortality ratio divided by the general fertility rate is equal to maternal mortality rate. What is the general fertility rate? General fertility rate is the number of live births in a year divided by the mid-year female population in the age group 15 to 49 multiplied by 1000 will give you. This is the relation of maternal mortality as well as the fertility is established through this kind of a ratios. The third measure of maternal mortality is the proportion of adult female deaths due to maternal cause. This is derived as the number of maternal deaths by female deaths in the age group 15 to 49. If you look at the maternal mortality rate, that gives the number of maternal deaths divided by the number of females in the age group 15 to 49, whereas this denominator here, that is the proportion adult female female deaths, the denominator refers to females in the age group 15 to 49 of their deaths. Therefore, proportional mortality refers to the ratio of maternal deaths among the female deaths in the reproductive age. Therefore, the denominator is adjusted according to the females in the female death in the age group 15 to 49. And other one is the very important one is the adult lifetime risk for maternal deaths. This adult lifetime risk of maternal death is the probability that a 15 years old woman will die eventually for a maternal cause in a given time period. In this, the measure of women above 15 years of age is considered. Because according to the Indian system, early marriages will be there. There is the risk of maternal death less than 15 years also. But as a standard pattern, it has taken into the 15 years age, above 15 years of age. And the end period is taken as a 50 years of age, not the 45 years of age of the reproductive life. Therefore, the proportional maternal death is calculated as a T15 minus T50 divided by L15 multiplied by the maternal mortality rate. The T15 and T50 are the life table functions which can be derived from the female life tables which are existing outside of this cord. Therefore, this ratio, this adult lifetime risk mortality, is derived from the life table functions. Some other methods are there for calculating the lifetime risk that will be discussed in the indirect methods of estimation of maternal mortality in the next coming discussions. Then, what are the sources available? There are the direct and indirect sources available. Civil registration system, where it will keep the records according to the international classification of cause of death, and hospital records which are maintained by the hospitals, and as well as these are the two direct sources, and other one is the household survey, census, and reproductive age mortality studies, which will give you the indirect measures that will be discussed in the coming sections. Then the sources for the data, sample registration system is collecting the maternal mortality data through the vital registration system in India. Since it is collected on the sample basis, not covering the entire India, therefore estimates are derived by pooling the 3 years data which has been published by the vital registration SRS reports which are been given. These SRS reports on the special bulletins started since 1997 on the maternal mortality. If you see that, how to calculate the maternal mortality data by SRS which is given. For calculation of the maternal mortality, either you call it the rates or ratios, and lifetime risk also can be calculated. For that, you require the total number of women and the live births, maternal deaths. These are the three things which are required. Therefore, maternal mortality ratio, as per the definition, you can see that column number 4, that is the maternal deaths divided by the live births multiplied by 1 lakh will give you for India 130 during 2018. That shows that for 1 lakh pregnancies in India, there are 130 women in the age group 15 to 49 due to the delivery, they are dying, or within 42 days of after delivery they are dying. Whereas in the maternal mortality rate, calculated as the number of maternal deaths divided by the women in the age group 15 to 49 multiplied by 1000, that will give you the 8.8 for India from this table. This table also gives you the lifetime risk, which is estimated as the 1 minus maternal mortality rate divided by the 1 lakh subtracted from 1 to the power of 35 is calculated, and it is given in the according to the formula which is given the earlier. The table clearly shows that maternal mortality in the states such as Assam, Odisha, Rajasthan is very, very high. When it comes down to Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, it is very, very low. But whereas if you look at the maternal mortality rate of Karnataka is half of Assam, whereas Kerala is more or less 1/8, and whereas in Tamil Nadu it is 1/3 of Assam. Therefore, these states, southern states, are very low maternal mortality rate. That shows that number of women who are dying due to maternal deaths are very less in the southern states than the northern states. The causes and then the determinants will be discussed. The limitation of the direct method is that in the developing countries, vital registration is very poor, because the rates and ratios which has been calculated depends upon the first of all number of maternal deaths, and then the maternal deaths occurred within 42 days after delivery. These are the important thing of the numerator of this maternal mortality ratio as well as the rate. In that case, follow up will be very difficult. Second thing is that identification of the cause of death due to the pregnancy related complications is very difficult, because in the developing countries, non-health professionals or the persons who have no direct contact with the diseased person will be collecting the information. And most of the deliveries in India are taking place at home. Because of that, the identification of the cause of death will become a difficult part of it. Therefore, maternal mortality collection directly will become a complicated phenomena. As well as, you know very well, the registration of events, vital events, is also very poor in this India as well as a developed country. Then comes to the other measures, proportional mortality, adult mortality, all this, adult maternal mortality. Calculation requires life table functions. Therefore, we should have a life table functions according to the age, and for male and female, and female is most important, and calculation of lifetime risk of maternal mortality is becoming a difficult task. Therefore, there should be an alternative method, and we have to derive the alternative measure which is the robust, and it is very easy to calculate also. And one of the important thing is that the sample size of maternal deaths required very, very large to come to a kind of a reliable conclusions, because the number of deaths per number of labors, and it is multiplied by the 1 lakh population, 1 lakh deliveries. That is creating a problem in identification and calculation of the maternal mortality ratio. Therefore, the individually any researcher wants to calculate it, then it will become a difficult task for him to estimate the very larger sample to find out the accurate maternal mortality ratio as well as the maternal mortality rate. Therefore, we should find out the alternative approach, and that will be discussed in the coming sections.